So lots of violence, lots of fighting, lots of conflict, lots of sex. The way you guys make Banshees is the allegory of a sort of a messy modern world that we live in today.
I think, you know, in a way it captures the messy modern times. It what I always like is that there's no clear good or bad. Everybody can connect to having a secret or having something they don't want people to know, or if they did know, what would people think of them? And also, you know, at the end of the day, so many people are deeply emotional and feeling, and that's something that we never want to shy away from, is that people are reacting. You know, Lucas Hood is a very emotional character. He reacts, you know, he's got a knee-jerk reaction to things, and that comes with a consequence. So we take a lot of pride in the fact that the characters are very larger than life. I mean, the world is very larger than life, but the characters have a lot of humanity and a lot of things that people can really grab onto that we can all relate to. And who wouldn't want to live in a town that had so much color to it?
Can you talk more about the struggle of doing sort of emotionally grounded characters in such a heightened, pulpy setting?
Yeah, so the characters being emotionally grounded is something that came through with the casting. I think that's something that really Ivana and Anthony really brought to that. Mm-hmm. Jonathan's writing and season one and David's writing, but now especially this year, Jonathan, there's so much more complexities that are going on in terms of that writing, and that's something that both the cast brings. And we always want to make sure that it's, I've mentioned this before, but the real toads in the imaginary pond. It's the world can be heightened, but you don't need to have heightened characters. It still has to be somewhat grounded and be able to connect to it. I think the fearlessness that we tell the story is appealing to people, and I think that's something that is both, you know, Jonathan, who's never worked in television, and me, who has a real history in television, was the number one thing to break out from. It's like, let's go for it. We have nothing to lose. We know we're here for 10 episodes. I bet we're here for another 10. I bet we're here for another 10 after that. Let's go for it. Like, why not? Like, what do we have to lose? Yeah. Like, we're not gonna, like, we don't try to just do it to do it. We always make sure that it's grounded in character, grounded in story, but we try to make fearless and unexpected choices along the way, and I think people respond to that. Alexa Fogel is the casting director of Banshee. She cast Oz in The Wire, and I sought her out, and I called her on a weekend. She didn't originally, wasn't available to do the job, and I called her on a weekend to convince her to come, because it's exactly her strength of uncovering new talent that I wanted her for. And my dream cast of Banshee was a cast of people you either vaguely knew or didn't know to be there, so that they could come in and you only thought of them as their character. You didn't be like, oh, that's the guy from the other show, the thing. Or if you knew him, you're like, ah, that's the guy from that thing. Yeah. That was the most I wanted to do in terms of recognition. So my dream cast was the cast that completely inhabited the characters that you've never met.
Is there any sort of little tidbit of season two that you can share with your fans to entice them to continue watching?
To keep watching. I would say the great thing is that Banshee will always surprise you. You will never know what's coming from one episode to the next, and it's thrilling, and it's nothing, you know, being the fear of the unknown should not be feared. It's actually, we have a great journey in mind for everybody, and if they've seen season one or if they haven't seen season one, season two gives them an unexpected, incredible, and emotional and compelling journey. I promise you, when you get to the finale of this year, you will say that he promised and delivered. You know, one of the things that we wanted to make sure of is that we are a show that knows what the journey is going to be. We know where we're going to wind up. Now, that's not to say that ideas come and continue to sort of guide that journey, but we ultimately know kind of like where we want to be by certain points and what's going on. I've worked on a lot of things that didn't have that vision, or they were sort of winging it, or they went a season too long. I never want us to be that. We know what we are, we know how long we want to be here, and we know what story we want to tell. And that's important for the fan, because I feel that they feel that. We're laying, you know, season two lays pipe for season three, and season three is going to lay pipe for season four. And, you know, really, you know, I hope to be a five-year series that tells this very compelling five-year story. For me, I got into TV because I loved what TV's potential was. You know, I mean, I've been directing television for 20 years, so I've been able to see its evolution and see the way it gets consumed. I mean, I've been a binge watcher of television since they started releasing seasons on DVD. That's how I watched 24. That's how I watched Breaking Bad. I love that as a way to view it. If people choose to watch that way, that's awesome. There's part of me that still loves the week to week and the anticipation.
What's it cool about?
Yeah, well, I love the excitement of the unknown. And for me, that's how I enjoy it. So, you know, we've created Banshee to be something that people can watch like straight through, or to, you know, if they need to catch up. It has such force in which it moves that it goes that way. Is TV going that way? I feel like some TV goes that way. I feel like it's really going to be up to the appetite of the consumer. And the important thing for us with Banshee is that there's many ways that they can engage the story. And I've tried to put something there for everyone.